students, hope you had a great weekend. Welcome back to school and welcome to Finn. Before we begin this week's announcements, we would like to tell you a little bit about something called a land acknowledgement. Starting today, Ferris will be offering a land acknowledgement at the beginning of each school week, and we wanted to share a little bit more about this new tradition. You probably know by now that this was non-uninhabited land when early settlers arrived. Instead, millions of indigenous people whose traditional territory spanned the entire continent lived in what now is America. A land acknowledgement is a short statement that recognizes that Americans live today on land that was not willingly given. Acknowledgements seek to promote greater social and racial justice. The language of Ferris's land acknowledgement was developed by the Spokane tribe. Within Spokane tribe's acknowledgement that we are about to share, there are a few words that you might not know. Unceded. This means that the tribe's rights to their traditional homelands were never given up through treaty. Instead, the Spokane tribe's reservation was created through an executive order by President Hayes. The tribe's current reservation boundaries include only about 150,000 acres of roughly 3 million acres historically held. Since time immemorial. This phrase honors the fact that tribes' histories and relationships are deeply rooted in these spaces, even beyond recorded history. Our land acknowledgement shows respect for the indigenous people of our area and recognizes their enduring relationship to the land. In this way, we are raising awareness of histories that might otherwise be suppressed or forgotten.
We acknowledge that we are on the unceded lands of the Spokane tribe. The Spokane people shared this place with other tribes through their relations, resources, history, trade, and ceremony. We thank the caretakers of this land who lived and continue to live here since time immemorial. This land holds the knowledge, culture, and spirit of the people of the river.
Thank you to the Ferris administration for delivering this week's land acknowledgement. Before arriving at school each day, remember to complete the student health check and wear a mask that covers your nose and mouth. If you are in need of academic support, come to the After School Learning Center in the library Mondays through Thursdays. Go to the library after 6th period to check in. You can stay for a little bit to get your help, then leave, or you can stay until 4 o'clock when a bus is available to take you home. They have snacks. Ferris Spanish students are welcome and encouraged to attend Tortulia, a 7th-hour peer tutoring session to help you with your language proficiency. Wednesdays in Senora Morgan's room, M305, and Thursdays in Senorita Montefar's room in M303. Please talk to your Spanish teacher for more information. Spokane Virtual Learning, Summer 2021 and Fall 2021 to 2022, registration is now open. Register at www.spokanevirtual.com. If you have any questions, see your counselor. The Saxon Shack is now open. Call in an order to 354-6050 or email an order in to saxonshack@gmail.com, or you can even scan the QR code that's located throughout the building. Here is a short video highlighting many of the items available from the Saxon Shack.
Shack is open!
Calling all choir students. Canterbury Bells and Camerata auditions will be held the first week in May. Audition packets and information on student health sessions are available now in the choir room. Head to the choir room to get your audition packet. Do you have Saxon spirit? Are you interested in trying out for cheerleading? Get a front row spot to all the games. Ferris is looking for its 2021-2022 team. All current freshmen, sophomore, and junior girls and guys can try out to be part of cheer. Check out the Cheer Tryout webpage for more information on the requirements and come to one of the information meetings. Today, Monday, April 26th, or tomorrow, Tuesday, April 27th at 2 to 2:15 p.m. in Victory Plaza. Tryouts are Friday, May 14th, 2021. The Ferris Action Network is currently recruiting members. If you like helping the community, please consider joining this service-oriented club. Please contact Ms. Dietrich in room M202 or at the email on your screen for information. Film Club meets on Monday, April 26th after school at 2 o'clock in M507. And Photo Club meets after school at 2 o'clock in Mr. Cox's classroom on Tuesday this week. Skills USA Engineering Club students meet via Teams at 2 p.m. on Wednesdays. Stage Crew Club meets Tuesday and Wednesday after school, and the Theater Club meets on Thursday after school. For more information, see Ms. Cooper. Woods Club will meet after school at 2 o'clock in the Woods classroom on Thursday.
Wrestling preseason conditioning has already started and is held Mondays and Wednesdays from 2:30 to 4 p.m. Be sure to register in Family ID Season 3 Winter Sports under Wrestling. A current physical is required. For further information, contact Coach Vaughn by joining this reminding app. Text at Saxons WRE to 81010. Calling all gymnasts. We have an information meeting in the library on Wednesday, April 28th or Thursday, April 29th from 2 p.m. to 2:15 p.m. If you would like to participate in gymnastics, please attend one of these meetings. The season begins at the beginning of May. Be sure to register in Family ID Season 3 Winter Sports Gymnastics. Hey seniors, do you still need to order a cap and gown or additional announcements? There's still time to do so at www.spokanegrad.com. If you are a senior, be sure to check in at the College and Career Center for job opportunities. Seniors who are interested in being a speaker at graduation need to email a video of you reciting your speech to Mrs. Torres or Mrs. Jones by Friday, April 30th at 2 p.m. Speeches should be no longer than 3 minutes, and please stop by rooms M204 or M201 if you have any questions. That's it for Finn. Thanks for joining us today. Stay healthy, safe, and 6 feet away. And be sure to stay tuned for the post show.
Here at Ferris, we have classes. Now, I may have blown your mind a bit, but there's more. There is a very specific class that is responsible for many of the goings-on here at Ferris. But none of you really know what it is, do you? It's called Stagecraft Class, and it is one of the most important, yet one of the most elusive classes here at Ferris. And today, we'll be taking a look behind the scenes.
What would I like students at Ferris to know about stagecraft? I think the best thing I can say as far as letting Ferris know about what's involved in stagecraft is that we have stagecraft, and it's more than just being behind the scenes and opening and closing curtains. So if you like to build things with your hands, this is a great way to try it.
Now that you know all this, you may be thinking, how did such a wonderful class such as stagecraft ever come to be?
Got into teaching stagecraft when I started teaching theater the same year. I learned stagecraft in college, and my first job was working in a theater. So I have been working in theaters for a long time. And I learned that doing stagecraft in high school, you learn a lot just in 1 year. As opposed to stagecraft in college, you kind of take specific specialties and you work just in the costuming department or you work just in the lighting department. And in high school, we get to teach you a little bit of everything to kind of decide which direction you might want to go if you want to go in college.
But what are we exactly expected to do here at Stagecraft? Build thousands of amazing props which can be used on the set? Actually making the set for a wonderful performance? Designing crazy costumes and... I'm sure they're fine. But what do we do here?
In stagecraft class, the students do all kinds of things that are everything technical. So they do building the set, lighting the set, making sound beautiful for the actors, the makeup, the costumes, the advertising, They do front of house things. They sell tickets and they sell ads for the program. They make the program and posters and the advertising campaign.